Let me take the lead.
What's happening, everyone? Daniel here, founder of the DJB Photography School, based in Melbourne, Sydney, Perth, Brisbane, Auckland, and New York. In this video, I'm going to be showing you my exact settings on the DJI Mavic Air for photography and video. First of all, before I get started, I just want to let you know this video is definitely not a beginner's guide to using your DJI Mavic Air. There are some amazing videos on YouTube that you can watch to give you like a full-on from taking the Mavic Air out of the box to actually flying it. This video is not about how to fly the DJI Mavic Air. I'm just showing you my specific settings that I use to take photographs and make video in the most cinematic way possible. So as with every video that I make, I'm all about keeping things simple for you and for myself. And if you've ever opened up the DJI Go app before, you'll notice that, especially the first time you open it, it can be very confusing. There are so many different menus and options and things being displayed on your screen at the same time. It can be quite confusing. So my aim here is just to simplify everything for you and show you that it really isn't that complicated, even though it looks quite overwhelming on the face of it when you first open the app. So with photography on your Mavic Air, there are three main things that we want to change off the bat. The first thing is we want to put our drone into DNG RAW mode, we want to change the aspect ratio to 16:9, and we want to make sure that we're shooting in manual mode. With video, in order to make your footage the most cinematic possible, you need to slow everything down and try and avoid jerky movements. So we do that by adjusting the sensitivity of all the movements within the drone. So the first thing we want to do is tap on the three dots in the top right-hand corner of the display, and then under the first main controller settings, you'll see there on the left-hand side, the first menu option, we want to go to advanced settings and then sensitivity. Once you've done that, let's change the your movement limit down to 50. So next you want to go back, and this time we want to click on EXP. Now I'm going to explain this as simply as possible. Now it looks extremely confusing when you see these three little graphs and X and Y axes off the bat. All you need to know is imagine that your thumbstick is in the center of these three axes here. So see where that those yellow and green dots are? At the moment, that blue line is representing a linear sensitivity. So what that means is if you move the thumbstick to the far left of the motion, so the far radius of the motion of that thumbstick, if you move it to the far left, it's going to be as sensitive as it is on the inner radius. So what we actually want to do here is we can change how sensitive the inner radius is compared to the outer radius. So you can see here we can put our finger and just drag up and down on this curve, but what we actually want to do is set this to 0.1, and you'll see here that that graph has changed, and what that's saying is that the inner radius is less sensitive than the outer radius. So I'm going to go ahead and do that on all three of these graphs here. Now, what does that mean? So the reason this is so good is that if we want to make a fast move, we want to rotate quickly, we want to go up and down quickly, then we can just use the thumbstick to the full extent. But if we want to use it slowly and smoothly, then we can just use the inner radius of the thumbstick. So this is just kind of controlling the acceleration of the sensitivity. It looks a lot more complicated than it is when you just look at these graphs. But all you need to know is that when you stick within the inner radius of the movement of the thumbstick, it's going to be less sensitive and you're going to have more control. If you need to rotate quickly or you need to move quickly, then you can just pull the thumbstick to the extent of the radius of its movement. The next thing you want to do is go down to the gimbal settings, and we want to go to advanced settings, and here we want to change the max gimbal pitch speed to 20, and the gimbal pitch smoothness, we want to set that to 20. So all we're doing here is slowing down all of the movements. So yaw and pitch, yaw is horizontal movement, pitch is up and down movement. We want to make that as smooth as possible, and slow it down from the original settings. The reason for this is I found that straight out of the box without changing anything, the default settings are quite fast and it's very hard to control the movement of the drone when it moves around very quickly. So we want to slow it down so we have more control over it, and we'll also make it look more cinematic. Once you've done that, close that off, and then on the right hand side here, you'll see these three little lines with little dots on them. Tap on that, make sure you're in video mode, and then we'll have the settings for the video. So if you don't know about manual mode, you need to learn manual mode first. If you're doing photography or video on your drone, you need to understand manual mode. So learn about that first. I have a video about that. I'll link it in the description. But the same concepts apply on a digital camera as they do on a drone. So understanding manual mode is very important when you are flying a drone and creating imagery and photography with your drone. So on the first tab here, you'll see that you have control over the ISO and shutter speed. And obviously this will change depending on what you're shooting. Remember that on these drones, still the high ISO handling is very bad. So anything that's above 100, it's going to be pretty terrible. You want to keep that in mind when you're shooting. Even though it goes up to 3200 ISO, you want to keep that as low as possible because the noise on these drones, even at ISO 100, is not great. Anything above ISO 100 does get quite noisy. When it comes to shutter speed, there are some things you want to keep in mind, and these same things apply to when you're creating video on your digital SLR as well. And that is that we obviously use shutter speed firstly to control the exposure, to control how bright or how dark we want the image to be. But we also, when we're making video, we want to make sure that the shutter speed is around twice the frame rate. If it's too fast, then your image starts to look kind of jittery. And if it's too slow, then you'll get skipping frames. So what that means is if you're shooting at 24 frames per second, you want your shutter speed to be on around 1/50th to 1/60th. If you're shooting on 60 frames per second, then you want that shutter speed to be around 1/20th. Now let's go to the middle tab. Now here is where we set up all the sort of file settings and compression settings. There's not too much to think about here. The first thing is video size. So if you want to be shooting in 4K, then you can do that. If you just want to shoot in normal HD, you have that option down here, 1080p. We want to be shooting in 24 frames per second most of the time because 24 FPS is the cinematic frame rate that we use if you want cinematic looking footage. If you want to make slow motion footage, then you can shoot in 60 frames per second and then slow it down in post-production. The thing is here with the Mavic Air, we don't have that option on full 4K resolution to shoot in 60 frames per second. So you'll notice here that we can shoot in 60 FPS when we're at 2.7K or when we're at full HD, which is, they're obviously lower resolutions, but they allow you to shoot in faster frame rates. So that's the video size. The next thing we wanna do is have a look at our video format. I choose MP4 all the time. White balance, cloudy. Now again, this changes depending on what you're filming. If you're outdoors, which you usually are with a drone, I pretty much leave mine on cloudy all the time, never use auto. And again, this white balance thing and color grading your footage is something that we look at again in post-production. So you want to get a good baseline setting while you're shooting. So cloudy is good if you're shooting outdoors. You can even go down to custom and choose an actual temperature, a color temperature, if you want to do that as well. But the main thing to remember here is that if you want your footage to look professional, to look cinematic, then you have to be doing some form of color grading in post-production. I do color grading in Final Cut Pro X, and this sort of stuff relates back to photography and how we use our raw files to develop in Lightroom. Same thing with video, we color grade our MP4 files in Final Cut. Now let's go back from white balance, let's go down to style here. This is where you can sort of add some little sharpening, and they have some presets here. I pretty much leave this on standard all the time because I like to do all of this contrast and color adjustment stuff in post-production afterwards on my computer. Now let's go back to the main menu, go down to the last one, color. We only have two options here, D-Cine-like and normal. I leave mine on D-Cine-like all the time. I found that with D-Cine-like, I just get a better baseline setting to work with in post-production in Final Cut. And the last tab here is the settings. You don't really need to worry about this. These are just sort of viewing options that we have. The only thing that I put on is the grid. And that's because I like to see when my horizons are straight and I use that grid to make sure that everything is straight when I'm shooting. Okay, so now let's check out the options for photography. Let's flip this over, tap on where the video is. You'll see that changes to a little camera. And we'll go back to the three lines, and you can see here we have the same sort of options on the far left tabs. These are just the manual mode settings. Again, We have a fixed aperture on the drone, so we can change the ISO and the shutter speed as we need to control the exposure when we're taking photographs. Let's go over to the middle tab here. Now you'll see we have a few options here. The first thing is the photo. We have different modes here. So if you're trying to use the timer or you're trying to make a panorama, you can do that here. I usually leave mine on single shot mode. Let's go back to image size. I prefer to shoot on 16:9, but this is a personal preference thing. If you want to shoot 4:3, go ahead and choose that option. I just prefer the wider, more cinematic option of 16:9. We want to, in image format, we want to be shooting on RAW. I don't bother shooting on JPEG and RAW. As you know, everything is done in RAW. We take our RAW files into Lightroom and then we develop the RAW files afterwards in post-production. Next, we have white balance. Now remember, because we're shooting in RAW here, white balance is something we can change in post-production, something that I always change in post-production. So what you choose here is just going to be, for the meantime, what you see when you play back that image on your phone. This is not going to make a difference when you take it onto your computer. So leave it on cloudy for the most part, and remember that you change that in post-production. Let's go back to the main menu, style, none. Again, we want to leave this on standard. This is something, if you're shooting in JPEG mode, this will make a difference, but if you're shooting in RAW and you're developing your photographs in Lightroom, then you don't need to worry about these options at all. And the last thing is color. We're just going to leave that on normal. When we go over to the settings, you'll see that pretty much we have exactly the same options. The grid is on, and that's all we need to think about. That's it for all of the in-camera settings for my drone. As you know, with photography, all of my development work is done with the DNG RAW files in Lightroom afterwards, and same thing with the video. All of the video color grading stuff is done in Final Cut Pro, but the main thing you want to think about with video is that to get it to look as cinematic as possible, you want to slow everything down, and that was really the purpose of changing all of those settings on the drone this time. So right now I've made a little slideshow with some photography and some video. If you have any questions, please write a comment below, and I always get back to everyone. If you liked this video, please subscribe and give it a like, and thank you very much for watching. I'll catch you next time. Let me take the lead. All right. Streets, what's a guan is? I heard you a single man. You know what I like, I don't know shy. You know what you need to do. Baby, baby, Canada, I can even take you there. Maybe we go China. Let us go around the world.